Now, the New Zealand sea urchin, or kina, is one of those things everyone has an opinion on. To add fuel to the debate, there are now too many of them.
The kina population has exploded, and the hungry herbivores are clearing out the seafloors. Ben Hurley went to see how we can manage the population with our appetites.
Few edible animals are as polarising as the New Zealand kina. Kina is not as discerning, however, and is one of the most voracious herbivores in the ocean, clearing large amounts of reef and causing, well, an eco issue.
I've been harvesting kina probably since I was about 5 years old commercially. The old man started he wanted to do a diving business back in 1997, I think, and no one had really got around to doing kina. We couldn't even buy a kina in New Zealand before he got into it.
So how popular is kina in New Zealand?
It's getting pretty very popular, considering back when we started, it's 7 or 8 times as big.
However much we're eating, it's not enough, because they're a real problem, aren't they?
There is a bit of a problem with an overpopulation of kina, yes. And I do think that if people start eating a few more and realising how good they are, then we'll slowly get on top of how many there are out there.
Very simple question, how do you get them?
In New Zealand, all the commercial kina diving is all done free diving, so no tanks, no air. It's a simple hold your breath, swim down with a so-called rake and a small kit or a bag, and it's literally hold your breath and start picking them off the rock. It's one of the most sustainable ways of methods of fishing, and is also zero bycatch, so we don't take anything else that's not targeted apart from kina.
So eating kina is just a win-win-win situation, really.
Yeah, at the moment it's bloody good for you, it tastes good, and it's also helping the environment.
These came out of the water this morning?
They are moving, mate. Look at that, they're still going, still moving.
Oh, they are.
Fresh air, still alive. We get our fancy dangle cracker, and what we do is we just push them in and break them open. Then we get a long-handled teaspoon, open them up.
This is the bit where you said, like, not everybody likes the look of it, right?
Oh yes, it can be a little bit off-putting if you're not used to it. And it's a matter of scooping that out. Delicious.
Just eat that?
Just like that, mate. I'll join you if you want.
Cheers.
Cheers, mate.
If you've never had one before, and I've had them plenty of times, I reckon it's somewhere between the flavour of an anchovy and the texture of an oyster. Am I a million miles away?
No, you're right, yeah. Anchovy, yep, I can definitely give that. The texture I find is just as a mat, it's just moist the way it melts in your mouth.
So I want to run an idea past you. Okay, we want people to eat more kina, right?
Good.
What if we put them as part of the most eaten food on earth?
Chicken, no?
Pizza.
Pizza.
So I took my ocean floor gold and headed to someone who knew about pizza. Luke, from the famous Kuatunu pizza spot, Luke's. Luke.
Hey, mate.
How are you?
All good.
Thanks for doing this.
Yeah, all good. Pleasure.
Because this is a bit of a challenge for you.
Yeah.
I've got a box full of kina here.
Yeah, yeah. I've heard.
Now, how long have you been making pizzas here?
It's been a good 14 years now. I've been cracking away here.
Have you ever put kina on a pizza?
No, not yet. I like kina.
Yes.
But I've never put it on a pizza. We've pretty much tried everything else, but not kina.
Okay, well today's the day.
Yeah, right, let's do this. Lots of people choose to put anchovies on this prawn pizza.
Yeah.
So
how's it? That's not...
As well, so...
I mean, that's quite a lot.
You're right, mate. You're going to be eating this.
Okay.
I'm not worried. I'm the chef, you know? Like,
yeah, that's true. It's only your reputation that you've built up over 14 years.
Oh, I can smell the aroma of these beautiful little rows. Righty-ho, Ben. I've given it a crack. I've done my bit. We've got some cooked ones. We've got some raw ones.
Mm-hmm.
Your turn.
I gotta go sell it.
Yeah, yeah. Please don't clear the restaurant, eh? Keep some customers here if you can.
I'll do my best.
Mm-hmm. See how it goes.
Wish me luck. Excuse me. Hello, how are you? Can I interest you in a new creation that we've just invented? You're running away? Wow, that was a definite no. Have you ever had sea urchin or what we call kina before?
Never had a sea urchin.
It's not that bad.
Okay.
It's good.
I mean, that's...
I'd give that 9 out of 10.
9 out of 10?
Oh, wow.
I love that it's not that bad as 9 out of 10.
That's lush.
Lush?
Yeah,
good. I think that's good. Lush is good.
Oh, it's delicious. Really yum.
Yeah?
It's quite very salty and beautiful.
What do we think over there?
Delicious. Same. Very Thanks. Fishy.
Yes.
Nicer than they look.
It's anchovies on steroids. It's delicious.
Okay, this is going unbelievably well. I'm going to try one more. Excuse me, mate. Sorry to interrupt. Would you like... now, this is kina and... Hang on a minute. Well, I think I know how this is going to go, but...
I think that works, eh?
Oh, funnily enough.
That is on. That is on. It's fitting in quite nicely, actually. I think I'd go with another.
Okay, a completely unbiased opinion there by the man who literally picked these off the ocean floor. But I think it's looking pretty good for the kina pizza.